Hi student, this is Krishna Jogaji. Now I am going to explain the process of oogenesis in the female. So in previous classes we discussed about the spermatogenesis. So that is continuation class is oogenesis. What is mean oogenesis? Oogenesis means the process of formation of female gametes is called as oogenesis. So the process of formation of mature female gametes is called as oogenesis. The oogenesis is initiated during the embryonic development stage in the female. So in the males, the spermatogenesis is started at the puberty stage, but in the female, so that is started at the fetus stage, growing stage. So the each fetus ovary consists 2 millions of mother gamete cells. Mother gamete cells. In the each fetus ovary contain 2 millions of mother gamete cells. So these cells are called oogonia. So these cells are called oogonia. So these oogonia, so present in 2 millions in each ovary, after they do not multiply, so these oogonia are started meiosis division. So these oogonia cells start meiosis one division, but it is stopped prophase one stage. At this stage, these are called primary oocyte. So these primary oocyte growing within the Graafian follicle of female. Graafian follicle or ovarian follicle. So now we discuss about the how the formation of Graafian follicle in the ovary of female. So let's see. So how to formation of Graafian follicle. So this is the primary oocyte. The primary oocytes next surrounded by the flattened cell layer. So now at this stage, these follicles are called primordial follicle. So within the primordial follicle, the primary oocytes. So the primordial follicle are formed. So large number of primordial follicle are degenerating. So in the phase between the birth to puberty stage. So remaining 60,000 to 80,000 primordial follicle are left in the each ovary of female during the puberty stage. So later, these primordial follicle convert into cuboidal cell layer. After these cuboidal cells, so proliferate to the granulosa cells, condense to form membrane granulosa. Here cuboidal cells, now this is the membrane granulosa cells. At this stage, the Graafian follicle are called primary follicle. After these granulosa cells, between the primary oocyte and the granulosa cells, a homogeneous membrane are formed. So these membrane also comes from the granulosa cells, but instead of granulosa cells are form a homogeneous membrane, so that is called zona pellucida. So here we have to see granulosa membrane. So between the granulosa and primary oocyte, another membrane are formed. This is called as zona pellucida. So the innermost cells of granulosa cells, inside cells, firmly attached to the zona pellucida and form another membrane So our call is corona radiota. Corona radiota. So this is present outside of the zona pellucida. So now three layers are there: zona pellucida, corona radiota, granulosa. The zona pellucida is covered immediately outer side of the primary oocyte. After corona radiota are there, after so zona pellucida. So this is about the zona pellucida. So next, a antrum is appear within the granulosa cells. Antrum means a space, a sac like structure. So that is appear within the granulosa cell. So this is called as antrum. So the antrum are in gradually increasing size. So the result is the outermost layers of granulosa cells is convert leads to relatively thin. The antrum, the spaces appear within the granulosa cells, so gradually increasing, so the outer cells becomes thin. So next, so the primary oocyte that is lies eccentrically, means it is most one side, so it is most peri. Thereafter, so these primary oocytes also covered by the granulosa cells. So this primary oocyte attached one side eccentrically and peripheri, and externally covered by membrane granulosa cells. These cells is called as cumulus puporus. So this is about the cumulus puporus. Outside of the granulosa cells, some stromal cells, so surrounding the membrane granulosa, stromal cells. What is mean stromal? Stroma means the inside of the ovary. So the ovarian cells means stromal cells that is surrounded outside of the granulosa cells. So and which is proliferate and also condensed to form another membrane. So this membrane is called theca interna. The theca interna secretion of hormone. This is the estrogen hormone. So the before only here granulosa cells are there. Outermost granulosa, stromal cells are surrounding, and which is condensed to form the layer that is called theca interna. Theca interna is secrete the estrogen hormone. Next, some fibrous cells of the ovary that is surrounded by the theca interna and form another membrane. So this membrane is called as theca externa. So at this stage these follicles are called secondary follicle. So next, within the secondary follicle, so the primary oocytes now start meiosis division and complete the meiosis one division. So this is unequal division. So remember, unequal division and produce the result is formation of a large haploid secondary oocyte and another one teeny polar body. So if this is the unequal division, yes, the result is unequal. So this is the mature secondary oocyte, this is large, this is polar body, that is not oocyte, polar body. The secondary oocytes retains the So maximum cytoplasm from the primary oocyte. So this is the completion of meiosis one, and this secondary oocyte again start the meiosis two division, and stop the metaphase. Within the graafian follicle, so ovarian follicle later. So this is after changes, it is convert to mature graafian follicle. So this is about the formation. This is about the formation of graafian follicle. Now ovulation. So ovulation means the ovum is released from the ovary is called as ovulation. Once again, ovulation means the ovum released from the ovary are called as ovulation. So the graafian follicle, so in the first is very small when compared to the the cortex of ovary. After it is again growth, and increase the big size, and also it is look a bulging like structure, a bulb like structure, and it is reach so outside of the ovary. So the external ovarian follicle raptor, the ovum is released from the ovary. So this is called as ovum. So when releasing ovum are not fully mature, because so it is arrested at the meiosis two division, metaphase meiosis two division. So this is about the ovulation. Next, Corpus luteum. So the corpus luteum means when ovulation completed, so here remaining granulosa cells become a yellowish mast cells. So these remaining granulosa yellowish mast cells are called as corpus luteum. So the corpus luteum is secreting the progesterone hormone, right? So this progesterone hormone is very essential to the So this corpus luteum is persist for 14 days. If releasing ovum not fertilized, so the corpus luteum time is persist the 14 days. So the end of this corpus luteum, if not fertilized ovum, so this yellowish cell mass, it is converting to the whitish cell mass. So it is degenerating end of the life. So it is look a white moss, white color moss, white color moss. So this is called as Carpus albicans. Carpus albicans, albicans. So this is the Carpus luteum. So if worm is fertilizing, so the Carpus luteum is persist the 3 to 4 months. 3 to 4 months. So this Carpus luteum produce the progesterone hormone. So this is very essential to the pregnancy maintenance, pregnancy implantation, and so that like pregnancy important is very essential. So this is about the progesterone hormone. And after 4 months, 3 to 4 months, these progesterone hormone is produced by the placenta. So after 4 months, this is no longer. So because the placenta produce progesterone hormone. This is about the Carpus luteum.